The final song today is by Cole Porter. If you remember the movie The Philadelphia Story from the 1930s with Katharine Hepburn and who were the other people in that? James Stewart, was he one of them? Whatever. I think that's right. Well, anyway, she was a society girl in the main line, etc. They made a movie musical of it in the 50s, and Cole Porter was contracted to write the songs for it. So the other than the song I'm going to sing, the other one that comes to mind that I always liked was the duet that Bing Crosby and Frank Sinatra sing. Did you see da 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 da? Well, did you ever? What a swell party this is, if you remember that. Anyway, this is just a very straightforward ballad, and I think it was sung by Bing Crosby primarily in the movie. He was the one who sang it. This reminds me of, because it's in the 50s, I think that Cole Porter was a little bit inspired by the sound of Elvis even. It reminds me of Love Me Tender, because it's nice and simple and it has a nice B section. That's really comes from a folk song called Oralee that was written separate lyric. New lyrics were written to it for Love Me Tender. The other thing this true love song is a waltz. Cole Porter, another famous waltz he wrote is in Kiss Me Kate, which was also in later in his career. Wunderbar, wunderbar, bum bum ba-da-dee-da-da. There's a little bit of that in this, and I was trying to think of other really well-known songs from musicals or movies that are in 3/4. Another one is from MAME, You're my best girl and nothing you do is wrong. I'm proud you belong to me. There was another one I was thinking of too, but Moon River is in 3 also. Moon River. Oh, I was thinking of this one. Edelweiss, Edelweiss. A nice simple AABA 3/4 song, which is exactly what true love is. But this is very pretty and has some unusual changes, even though it's simple. The chord changes are a little bit unusual.
Guardian angel on high with nothing.
I don't think he lived much longer after that. You know, he had been in the horse riding accident and was paralyzed, was in a wheelchair for the last part of his life. But he never lost his touch, there's no doubt about it. He was writing in the 20s all the way till the 50s.